Hello, I'm Lynette.
And I'm Eli.
Welcome to the first of our films for this year's Self-Denial Appeal. For this year's Self-Denial Appeal, we're focusing on children and young people and how the Salvation Army is supporting, enabling, caring for, and being changed by children and young people around the world.
But before we get into that, let's look at last year's appeal.
Last year, we focused on caring for creation. Captain Joe Moyer talked to officers and staff in Kenya, Indonesia, Costa Rica, and Bangladesh. And we heard about the impact of climate change on the Salvation Army's work and what it's doing to combat it. Thank you for digging deep. You gave so generously, and your self-denial money is already making a difference.
You may be wondering, what is self-denial? But even if you do know, here's a reminder.
Self-denial is an appeal that happens every year to raise money for the work of the Salvation Army around the world. Almost all Salvation Army Corps take part, not just here in the UK and Ireland, but all over the world. And it's been around for a long time. William Booth introduced the idea to the Salvation Army way back in 1886. The idea stuck, and we've been doing it ever since.
Self-denial gives us time to reflect and think beyond our borders to the Salvation Army's international work. We are part of a global movement, and self-denial gives us the opportunity to support the Salvation Army financially across the world. Some people see it as a challenge to go without something for a week or a month and give the money they've saved to the appeal. Some people give a week's salary. You might have heard of OSAM's 1 week salary on missionary service. That probably involves a bit of advanced planning.
Some of the money we give goes to our mission partners. They are Denmark and Greenland, Finland and Estonia, Ghana, including Togo, Pakistan, and South America East. All the rest goes to international headquarters in London. They send it to the places that need it most, and it supports the mission of the Salvation Army around the world. It funds the background things, like church infrastructure, all the essential things that enable Salvation Army officers, staff, and volunteers to do what they're good at.
Now, we can't cover everything that the Salvation Army does in a few short films. So like previous years, we're focusing on just one part. This year, it's children and young people.
That doesn't mean this year's money will go exclusively to youth projects. It does mean that your self-denial money will support the global mission of the Salvation Army, and that includes the amazing work it's doing supporting children and young people. As the world recovers from the COVID-19 pandemic, other problems are troubling our planet. In these uncertain times, many millions of children and young people are caught up in difficult circumstances that are not of their making. Wherever it's at work, the Salvation Army is doing what it can to equip, enable, and support them. For the next few weeks, we'll hear from three young people in Kenya, Moldova, and Pakistan. We'll hear about some of the challenges they are facing and how the Salvation Army is supporting them. We'll be hearing from Jasfrida in Kenya. She was born with spina bifida, a condition which has affected her mobility and means she needs crutches to get around. Because of her disability, she's faced bullying and discrimination. We'll be hearing from Dimitri. He's from Ukraine, but he's in Moldova at the moment. He's one of the millions of people who fled Ukraine to escape the bombing. And next week, we'll be hearing from Joyce in Pakistan. Joyce is part of the Salvation Army in Lahore, Pakistan's second largest city. It can be hard for any young person to reach their dreams, but in Pakistan, if you have a Christian faith and you're a woman, it makes things harder. Joyce isn't put off. Her dream is to become a doctor.
There are quite a few ways to give to self-denial. You can use the envelope or this year's collection box. There's this QR code that links through to salvationist.org.uk. Or, if you have a standing order set up already, you can make a payment that way. Have a word with your core treasurer.
Well, that's all for today.
We look forward to seeing you next time.